Hello guys, happy new year. Happy new year from Peter, your Christian vlogger, your brother. Happy new year to all the chosen fans, and not only, but this video, if you allow me, especially made for the chosen fans. I am one of those that my heart is beating harder every single time when I watch The Chosen. Happy New Year to you, brother, that you just discovered The Chosen. And I know that you're mesmerized by what you see in this beautiful show. Happy New Year to you, sister. You as well, you heard about The Chosen and you decided to watch. And I can see you when you're watching, tears are falling from your eyes. You are laughing as well. To all those beautiful or funny moments that show Jesus and his disciples being so much real. There's so many testimonies of people from all over the world that are watching The Chosen, and they say that they love this human Jesus and his disciples. He was and he is one of us, a real human being. Not that Jesus that you see there in the icons, so distant. A beautiful art, but just art. No, not that Jesus, but a Jesus that you feel that he is one of you. A Jesus that smiled. A Jesus that was sarcastic. A Jesus that cried. A Jesus that was excited around his friends. Have you seen episode 3 from The Chosen? Look behind me what I put. Jesus and Lazarus. Beautiful friendship indeed. Very plausible that this happened. We don't know. But because the creators of The Chosen, they have this artistic expression freedom. The freedom to express themselves from an artistic point of view. They can imagine something like that, and this, as I said, could have happened. The Bible says clearly that Jesus and Lazarus were good friends. They come from the same town anyway. They loved each other. There was a deep connection between him, Lazarus, and his sisters. And the scripture speaks about this. So all of these majestic creators of The Chosen, they imagine this backstory that oh, have you seen, again, have you seen season 3, episode 3? If you haven't seen it just yet, take a look. Take a look and you will not regret. I've seen it. I watch it. I think 2 times. I know, 1 time and then I tried again to watch it. But to me, it's hard for me to watch again and again. If I watch 1 time, I'm that kind of person that I watch 1 time and I absorb everything that I see. And then it stays with me for months. And this is what happens when you watch The Chosen. Either is season 3 now, episode 3. Episode 4 is coming. Yes, today. 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Don't miss it or you'll regret it. But if you miss it live, you can watch it again. It will stay on YouTube, on Facebook for 3 days. And then they will remove it from there. But it will remain always on The Chosen app, the new Chosen app. I install it on my Roku TV. On my Roku gadget, and it's awesome. I can watch now everything there. Also, you know, there is this after show when the episode ends. They make a round table, and all the actors involved in the episode, they talk with each other about what happened. But let's go back to what I said. Happy birthday to you, my brothers and my sisters that love The Chosen. You have made such a big difference in my life. I am passionate about this channel. Why is that? I'm not monetized, so you know. I'm passionate because I can outreach. I'm passionate because I can get in contact with people. I'm passionate because I see people there commenting, and then I can answer. We can have a nice debate. Sometimes there is abuse as well, but I don't answer abuse, so I just delete it. I pray for that person. Always pray and love those, especially those that are unlovable. Because Jesus loved and loves us. And let's be honest, how many times has we been unlovable too? We are human beings. And we fall short of God's glory. We fall short of God's standard. God has a standard. He says we should reach up to here, and we can't. We fall short again and again. But because of God's love through Jesus, because God sent his only son, Jesus, to pay the price of us falling short, now we can consider God our Father. How amazing that is. And the Chosen shows this perfectly. Happy birthday to every one of you. Maybe some of you, you are celebrating your birthday today, 1st of January. So happy birthday to all the Chosen fans that are born today, 1st of January. If any of you is celebrating his birthday today, hit me up in the comments. Let me know, and we will celebrate together with you. Happy New Year to all of you, the Chosen fans. And not only, but again, especially the Chosen fans. How many of you, you came on my channel, you watched the video, that awesome video with Jonathan Rumi, being on Fox News and him answering to their questions. Regardless of Fox News putting Jonathan at an hour, a bit impossible to watch late in the night, so many watched the interview. Either it was live or either it was afterwards. And so many of you came as well on my channel. And I had, just because of that video, over 740 new subscribers. Can you imagine this to a small channel like mine? Thank you guys to all of you that decided to hit that subscribe button and to listen to me. I really appreciate and I love you. All of you, brothers and sisters, my friends. Together we're strong. Happy New Year to all of you. But I want to tell you something. There is a text that comes now in my heart that I want to share with you. Because we want a happy new year. We want 2023 to be happy for us, isn't it? To be a year in which we'll be blessed. A year in which we will win battles in our daily struggles. Because life is a daily struggle, isn't it? Just like Job said. The life of a Christian, the life of a human being per se, is like the life of a laborer, a day worker. It's hard. It's hard. And if you want to understand what Job actually was speaking, imagine a laborer thousands upon thousands of years ago in that heat of the Palestine, having to work long hours in that sun. Oh, the desire for water. Oh, the desire just to sit and take a long, deep breath and rest. But at that time, it was not like this. You had someone behind that was observing every move you made, and you were not allowed to make too many of breaks. That's why when Job speaks about the life of us, human beings, Christians, being exactly like the life of a laborer, it makes so much sense for many of us, because 2022 for many of us was a year filled with struggle, filled with maybe even personal tragedies. I can vouch. So this, not personally, praise God, but I have friends that they've been affected. Friends that they lost their brother at an early age. So 2022 was a rough year. But to come back to the verse that I wanted to share with you, my beloved chosen family, all of you, chosen army. I love you all. 1 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. I want to share this with you. And if we subscribe to this verse, then there will be a happy new year. There will be a year filled with blessings, filled with victories upon victories. We will see God working on our behalf, and we will see the battles that, as I said, we wage battles. We see them won one by one. 1 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14 speaks about, if my people, us, who are called by my name, we are called by his name, we're Christians, will humble their heart. Let's humble our heart. That is the first. We'll cleanse their hands. That's the second step. We will cleanse our hands. We'll not want our hands to be dirty. No, we don't want that. We don't want to want to be involved in things of this world. We want to be busy doing God's work, to be busy forwarding God's kingdom. And the third thing, very important as well, capital importance, for fight the wicked ways. Maybe there are things in our life that are still holding us back. Maybe there is that a secret addiction that nobody knows about and we're struggling with it. But that's a wicked way. It needs to be for fight. We will have our freedom and deliverance in the name of Jesus. So if all these three things that I share with you, we subscribe to, then God from heaven will hear our voice, will hear our prayer, and it will heal our land. Is your land the United States of America? If it is, I know, as you are a Christian, you've seen so much wickedness and it befall the United States of America, like never before in 2022, but because of 1 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14, as we'll subscribe to that, as all of us will come together. Let's start with us, the chosen fans. All of us will come together as one and we'll pray and fast for the United States of America, and not just for the United States of America, but for the world. You will see a big difference. And all these dark waves that the devil sends to our world, because he's desperate, he knows that his time is coming, all these dark waves will not penetrate our communities anymore, our families anymore. The blood of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus, my friends, my chosen fans, my beloved brothers and sisters. Always believe, no matter how severe the trial is, no matter how hard it is for you, there is power in the blood of Jesus. And I speak this awesome power of the blood of Jesus upon your life. You, my beloved chosen fan. You, my brother. You, my sister. Happy New Year to all of you. And thank you so much for blessing me, coming close to my heart, being here on my channel. Let's make this year, 2023, a year to remember. And let's not expect someone else to do what we're supposed to do. It's the year in which you will speak up when you see wickedness. It's the year in which you, brother, you, sister, you'll come together, you'll pray together, you'll fast together, and God will move. God will move on our behalf. Exodus 14:14. The battle belongs to the Lord. You only need to be still. How? Still. Still in prayer. Still in fasting. Happy New Year to all of you, the chosen fans. I love you all. Stay close. And together we are strong. But through Christ, we are more than conquerors. Happy New Year to all of you. I love you all.